नमस्कार बच्चों, वेलकम टू दिस वर्चुअल क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट एपिसोड वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द सेंट्रल बैंक एंड इट्स फंक्शन, दैट इज द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड द फंक्शंस डन बाय द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया इन आवर कंट्री. मूविंग अहेड, वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यूज्ड बाय द सेंट्रल बैंक, दैट इज रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, टू कंट्रोल द क्रेडिट, दैट इज द फ्लो of money in the economy. We'll see here how and what are the steps are been taken by the Reserve Bank of India, that is the central bank, to control the credit creation by the commercial banks. So students, listen carefully. So when we talk about the control of credit creation by the commercial bank, these credit control are being controlled by the central bank. And when these credit control are being controlled by the central bank through some instrument, that means through some policy, that policy is being called as what? Monetary policy. That is the monetary policy of the central bank. So this monetary policy is further classified as the quantitative instrument to control the credit in the economy and the qualitative instrument. In this episode, we will detailedly study about the quantitative instruments used by the central bank to control the credit in the economy and the qualitative instruments. So first of all, we will see the qualitative. So what do you mean by qualitative measures or qualitative instruments adopted by the central bank to control the credit creation? Students, in the quantitative measure, or we can say that the quantitative instrument which are being used by the central government, here it is further classified as two policy rates, the policy of two rate system and two ratio policy. So in two rate policy and two ratio policy, what we can see here that the central bank, that is RBI, tries to control the credit in the economy made by the commercial banks through the way of two rate policy. So let's say the what are the two rate policy. So these two rate policies are what? The bank rate and the repo rate. Bank rate and repo rate. These two interest rates are the rate of interest on the loans offered by RBI to the commercial banks. So later we will study detailedly about how by these two rates the RBI tries to control the credit creation by commercial banks in the economy. And then we have two ratio policy. So the two ratio policy, even we have detailedly studied about these ratios in the previous episode, but here listen carefully. Two ratios are what? Cash reserve ratio, that is CRR, and the SLR, that is statutory liquidity ratio. So even the central bank can control the credit creations of commercial bank by affecting the ratios of CRR and SLR. So by these two bank rates and the bank ratios, the RBI can very easily control the credit creation made by the commercial banks in the economy. So that is what called as what? The quantitative measures or quantitative instruments used by the RBI to control the credit creation. So students, you have to keep in mind about these functions of RBI, the central bank, because when we are studying about the concept of deflation and inflation also, at that time when we study about the correction measures to correct the situation of inflation deflation in the economy, at that time also we have to know the meaning of CRR, SLR, bank rate and repo rate. So here, when we are studying about the functions of RBI, that is the instruments used by the RBI to control the credit creation in the economy, at that time, you should know how by these two bank rates and two ratios, the central bank controls the credit. Now moving ahead, we will see about the qualitative measures. That means the qualitative instruments used by the RBI to control the credit creation. Students, in the qualitative policy or the qualitative instrument, the RBI focus on select sectors of the economy. Here, the RBI will not affect the credit creation by the way of the bank rates or the ratios, but here by the advisory, by the directions given by the RBI to the commercial banks, the RBI tries to control the credit creation. So because of that, this policy is also being called as what? Policy of selective credit control. So here only the selective sectors of the economy is being controlled by the RBI through the way of commercial banks on credit creation. So what we can see in this method, that here through the way of advisory, the RBI tries to control the credit creation in the economy. So students, in the qualitative measures, that is through the way of margin requirement, rationing of credit, and through moral situation, the RBI tries to control the credit creation made by the commercial banks in the economy through the way of qualitative measures. So students, that is what the two types of instruments or two types of policy adopted by the central bank in every country to control the credit creation by commercial banks. So students, now listen carefully. Now we will study detailedly about these two instruments one by one. So first of all, we will move to the quantitative measures or the quantitative instrument used by the central bank to control the credit creation made by the commercial bank. So first of all, what I told you, that in quantitative measure, these instrument can be further classified as two rate policy and two ratio policy. So always keep in mind about this one. So what are two rate policy and two ratio policy? And apart from these two rate policy and two ratio policy, even RBI used to control the credit creation or control the supply of money in the economy through the way of open market operation. So not only by these two rate policy and two ratio policy, even by getting the direct business with the customers of the economy, the central bank tries to control the supply of money in the economy through the way of open market operation. So here in this episode, we will see all these three points one by one. So first of all, we will move to the two rate policy. As I told you that in two rate policy, we will study about the bank rate and the repo rate. So even in the earlier episode, we have seen the meaning of bank rate and repo rate. Though I will repeat the meaning again here. So bank rate are the rate of interest on the loans offered by the RBI to the commercial banks without any collaterals or without getting any kind of securities. Whereas the repo rates are the rate of interest offered by the RBI to the commercial banks with some collaterals, that is with having some securities on the borrowings made by the commercial banks from RBI. So by this way, we have to learn how the credit can be controlled. So students, look at the chart given here. With the help of this chart, we will try to understand the sequences, the effect of these bank rates, that is the bank rate and the repo rate, on the credit creation and how the central bank tries to control the supply of money or the credit made by the commercial banks in the economy. Students, here, whenever there is a rise in the bank rate or the repo rate, what will happen? If there is a rise in the rate of interest of these two rates, bank rates and the repo rates, you can very easily guess that here, at a higher rate of interest, the commercial banks will borrow less from the RBI. So when the commercial banks are borrowing very less amount or very less loan from the RBI, at that time, what will happen? The cash reserves kept with the commercial banks will be discouraged. That means they will be reduced. So by reducing the cash reserves of the commercial banks, the commercial bank will create less credit in the economy. So that will reduce the supply of money in the economy. So this will be done during the situation of inflation. So what the situation of inflation shows, that during the situation of inflation, we could see the value of aggregate demand will be more than the value of aggregate supply. So here what the RBI tries to do, here the RBI will tries to get the equilibrium stage of AD and AS. So when there will be an equilibrium stage between AD and AS, that situation will be called as what? The equilibrium stage in the economy. So to maintain the equilibrium stage, here the money supply or the purchasing power of people will be lowered, such that the aggregate demand, the excess demand in the economy can be brought down. So when the excess demand comes down or brought down by contracting the supply of money in the economy through the way of creating less credit. So you can very easily understand that when these two bank rate and the repo rate are being increased, the commercial bank will get a very less amount of loan borrowing from the RBI. When they borrow less, the cash reserve of these commercial banks will also get low. So even we have studied about the money creation, how the commercial bank create money with the cash reserves available with them. So at this time, what will happen? Due to the higher rate of bank rate and repo rate, the commercial banks will borrow less from RBI. So it will reduce, it will control the credit creation made by the commercial banks, such that the situation of inflation or the excess demand situation can be controlled and it can be brought to the equilibrium stage. Now we will see the second condition. What will happen when the bank rate and the repo rate will be reduced? When they are lowered by the RBI. Whenever these two bank rates and the repo rates are being reduced by the RBI, at that time it encourages the cash reserves of the commercial banks. The commercial banks will borrow more money, more loans from the RBI. When these commercial banks borrow more money from the RBI, that will increase the cash reserves of the commercial bank. So when the commercial banks are having a more cash reserves with them, at that time this will encourage to create more credit, to increase the supply of money in the economy by the commercial banks. So here we can very easily understand when the RBI will reduce the repo rate or the bank rates. So even whenever these repo rates or bank rates are being decreased, at that time the loans available with the commercial banks will also be lowered. Even nowadays you can see in our commercial banks, the loans provided by these commercial banks, it may be a car loan, house loan, property loan or the other kind of purchase loan, where we can see that the rate of interest are gradually decreasing day by day. So by this situation, you can very easily understand what is going on in our economy. That means the economy is suffering from the situation of deflation, that is deficit demand. So whenever the economy suffers from a deflation or deficit demand, at that time we can very easily understand that here the aggregate demand is lower than the aggregate supply. That means we are having a more supply in the economy against the demand. That means we are producing more. The value of goods and services which are produced in a year in an economy is more than the value of expenditure made on these produced goods and services in an economy during an accounting year. So here what the government and the RBI will try to do, they will try to bring up the aggregate demand. So when you want to bring up the aggregate demand to the higher rate, at that time the purchasing power, the availability of money in the economy should be raised. So how it could be raised? It could be only raised with the help of the credit control. That means what? When the commercial banks will give more credit, when they create more money in the economy, the supply of money will be increased. So by giving more loans, by making more borrowings by the customer, by the people in the economy from the commercial banks, it will increase the expenditure. That is the value of C, consumption expenditure and the investment expenditure. So when the RBI tries to increase the value of consumption expenditure, investment expenditure, that will increase the aggregate demand. So when the aggregate demand will be raised to the level of AS, that is aggregate supply, the economy will reach to the equilibrium stage. So here, whenever the situation of deflation occurs in the economy. At that time, the RBI tries to control the credit, or it tries to increase the credit creation in the economy by the way of reducing the repo rate and the bank rate. Now we'll try to understand the two ratio policy. Students, in two ratio policy, we have seen about the CRR and SLR. Cash reserve ratio refers to that proportion of cash reserve that from the total deposit of the commercial bank that must be kept with the hands of RBI. That means some proportion of that total deposit should be kept with the RBI. As we have learned in the earlier episodes, that the commercial bank could not lend all that money, or it could not advance all that money as a loan to the customer, which it receives as a deposit from the people. Here, the commercial banks are not allowed to lend all the money, all the deposits which are being received by these commercial banks as loan to the people. Whereas here, the commercial banks are being advised or restricted by the RBI to deposit some portion of their total deposit with the hands of RBI as cash reserves. So this is what the proportion that is being called as what? The CRR, cash reserve ratio. And apart from that, SLR, SLR refers to the proportion of the liquidity asset. The liquidity asset present with the commercial bank in the form of gold, cash, or in the form of any unencumbered approved securities. So these two ratios are being decided by the RBI. So the rate of SLR and CRR is also decided by the RBI. So again, we have to study about the two conditions of deflation and inflation in the economy. So how the commercial banks are being controlled by the RBI through the way of CRR and SLR on credit creation. So students, here also you can guess very easily that when the CRR rate will be reduced or increased, or when the SLR rate will be reduced or increased. So students, here in the situation of inflation and deflation, you can guess what will happen to these ratio, that is CRR and SLR. So whenever the economy is suffering from the situation of inflation, that is excess demand, what will happen? The rate of CRR will be increased. So when the RBI increases the rate of CRR, so generally what will happen? It will compel the commercial banks to deposit more reserves with RBI. So when they deposit more reserve with RBI, the cash available or the money available with the commercial bank for credit creation will be less. So at that time, what will happen? The commercial bank can create a less amount of credit. They can lend very less amount of advance to the people with its reserve. Why? Because you know that the money creation or the credit creation is depend upon the cash reserves of the commercial bank. So due to the increase in the CRR, the money multiplier, you know how the money is being created? Money is being created with the help of money multiplier. That is the value of K. K is equal to what? 1 by the RR, the CRR rate. Take an example. If the CRR rate is 4%, so what will the money multiplier? So money multiplier will be K is equal to 1 by 4. That gives a value of 25. That means with the reserves available with the commercial banks, it can create 25 times more than the cash reserves available with the commercial banks as its loan to the people. That means if a bank is having a thousand rupees in its deposit as the demand deposit, so with that 1,000 rupees, the commercial banks can create money up to 25 times more, that is 25,000. So only by having 1,000 rupees as demand deposit with the commercial banks, these commercial banks can advance nearly 25,000 as the loan to the customers. So that is what the money creation which we have studied about in the commercial bank. So here also, so whenever these rates are increased, so what will happen? The value of money multiplier will be decreased. So students, like CRR, the SLR rate also affects the money creation of the commercial banks. As we have studied in the CRR, the same way, whenever the economy is suffering from deflation or inflation, So during the situation of inflation, where we need to brought down the aggregate demand, we need to decrease the excess demand available in the economy. At that time, the money supply or the money creation of commercial banks will be reduced by increasing the SLR rate, as we have done in the CRR. So here, when we have the situation of deflation, where we could see the deficit demand in the economy, at that time the deficit demand should be increased to the level of AS, that is aggregate supply. So at that time, what the Reserve Bank need to do, it need to increase the purchasing power, or it need to increase the supply of money in the economy. So that could be done by lowering the SLR rate. So by these two ratios also, the Reserve Bank of India tries to control the credit control in the economy, or the supply of money in the economy. So students, after studying about these two bank rates and the ratios CRR and SLR, now we'll see one more instrument that is being used by the RBI as the quantitative instrument to control the supply of money in the economy, that is open market operation. Students, in the open market operation, the central bank directly involved in the transaction of selling and purchasing the securities in the open market, like national savings certificates, that is NSC. And by this one, here the central bank tries to soak, or it tries to contract the cash, that is liquidity cash available in the economy. Here also we can guess what will happen in the open market operation. When the economy is suffering from the inflation situation, where we have the excess demand, so to contract the money supply, or the liquidity cash available in the economy, to soak that cash, the central bank tries to sell its securities. So when they sell the security, that is national savings certificates, by this the people will invest their money, the people will do their expenditure in purchasing these securities from the RBI. So that will reduce the excess demand made by these customers, these people in the economy. So these are the three steps or three instruments used in the quantitative measures of a central bank to control the credit creation, or to control the flow of money supply in the economy. That is the two rate policy, the two ratio policy, and the open market operation. Okay students, after this we will study about the qualitative measures, or the qualitative instruments used by the central bank to control the credit creation made by the commercial banks. So in that one, first I told you that margin requirement. So what do you mean by margin requirement? So here the margin requirement is the difference between the value of security of the loan, the collateral which has been submitted by the customer to the bank, and the value of the loan granted. Take an example, if a person is getting a loan as a mortgage loan for rupees 1 crore for a loan of 80 lakh, the margin requirement in this case would be 20 lakh. So margin requirement is raised when the supply of credit needs to be curbed, and the margin requirement is lowered when the supply of credit is to be increased. Often the margin requirement is kept high for speculative trading activities. So students, so based on the situation of inflation, deflation, or to increase the deficit demand and decrease the excess demand, the margin requirement also reduced and increased. Now we will see about the credit rationing. Credit rationing is the fixation of different quotas for different business activities. That means whenever the loans are being made, or the credits are being made available to the consumer in the economy, at that time the RBI requests the commercial banks to be rational while providing these credit to different types of business activities. The rationing of credit is introduced when the flow of credit is to be checked, particularly for speculative activities in the economy. The central fixes credit quotas for different business activities. The commercial banks cannot exceed the quota limit while granting the loans to the customer. And at last, we have moral suasion. So in moral suasion, the central bank pressurizes these commercial banks to follow its directives. Though the commercial banks never ignore these kind of directives issued by the central bank, So, by the way of moral suasion, the central bank requests or pressurizes the commercial banks to follow its directives or to be restrict its credit creation during the situation of inflation and deflation. So, by the way of directives issued by the central bank, the commercial bank will reduce and it will increase the credit creation or the money supply in the economy based on the economic situation like inflation or deflation. So, based on this moral suasion, the commercial banks are directed to increase and reduce the credit creation supply of money in the situation of inflation and deflation. So students, you can very easily understand that whenever we have again the demand, that is the excess demand, that is the situation of inflation, it directs the central bank directs the commercial banks to more to give, to provide more credit in the economy. Whereas in the situation of deficit demand, that is a deflation in the economy, here they are directed to supply less money in the economy or to create less credit in the economy. So these are the three steps which are being taken by the central bank in the qualitative measures. So they are the margin requirement, credit rationing, and moral suasion. So students, these are the important instruments, the tools which are being used by the central banks to control the credit creation or to control the supply of money in the economy. So students, that's all for today. I hope you could understood the concept which I studied today, and based on today's learning, I have given some homework. So note on this homework. In case of any doubt, you can contact us. Okay students, that's all for today. From next episode onwards, we will be having the classes on the IED, that is Indian Economic Developments. Okay students, until then, keep learning, stay safe, stay alert. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.